pictures to show you today. Look at these two apples. One of them has some bruised spots. The other one looks nice and shiny. Which one do you think you would like to eat? Probably the nice shiny one. The bruised one might taste good too, but it's not looking as good as the bright and shiny one. The bright and shiny would be the best one. What about these two bags of cookies? One bag is full of good cookies, and the other one has some broken pieces and not very many cookies in it. Which bag would you want? You'd probably want the bag full of good cookies. I like cookies, even broken ones, but if I open this bag of cookie pieces, I'm probably just going to get crumbs everywhere and make a mess. Eating the whole cookies would be much neater. The apples, I could cut off the bruised part and throw it away, or I could eat the whole apple. In our Bible story today, we will hear how God's people were not giving him their best. Let's listen to hear what God tells them. Today's Bible story is from the book of Malachi. Malachi only has 4 chapters. It's the last book in the Old Testament. The Old Testament is made up of 39 books. And next week, we'll get to hear stories from the New Testament. Remember, all the stories in the Bible fit together to tell us the one big story about how God rescues sinners through his son, Jesus. God's people were back at home. That was good. God loved his people, and he wanted them to love and obey him. The priests were giving sick or hurt animals to God instead of their very best. That was bad. The priests were teaching wrong things about God. That was bad too. God sent the prophet Malachi with a message. God said, "Your job is to help people love me, but you are not doing that." Some people thought serving God is not good, but that is not true. God said he would punish those who did not love him, but he would send a messenger who would get people ready for the Messiah. God said, "Those who love and obey me will be mine," and that's good. Let's watch our Bible story video to find out more.
Hey everybody, it's me, Megan, and I'm Jessie.
Oh, Jessie, can you believe it? It's almost time.
Almost time for what, Megan?
Not what, who.
Okay, it's almost time for who?
Jesus!
Yay! Wait, I don't understand.
Today is our last Bible story in the Old Testament.
Oh, wait. No, I still don't get it. I thought all the Bible is about Jesus.
Good point, Jesse. Yes, all of the Bible is about Jesus. But the Old Testament tells us that Jesus is coming, and in the New Testament, Jesus comes.
Oh, now I see what you mean. Yay!
Yes. In today's Bible story, Malachi the prophet told that a messenger would come who would get people ready for the Messiah. That messenger was John the Baptist, and the Messiah is Jesus. Listen to the story.
The Jewish people were home in the Promised Land. They had worked hard to rebuild the temple and fix the walls around the city. The people were ready for God to bless them. They waited, but nothing happened. Some of the people were sad. They wondered if God really loved them. God did love his people. They had been doing wrong things, and God wanted his people to obey him.
So God sent the prophet Malachi to talk to his people. God gave Malachi a message, and then Malachi told the people what God said. Malachi told the people what they had been doing wrong. The priests were supposed to make sacrifices to God. God deserved the very best sacrifices, but the priests gave animals that were stolen, hurt, or sick. The priests were also supposed to teach the people about God, but the priests taught things that were not true. God was not happy.
Then Malachi gave a warning. He said that a day was coming when God would judge people on earth. God said, "I am going to send my messenger, and he will get people ready for me." The messenger God was going to send would have a very big job. The messenger would say, "Another messenger is coming, get ready." The other messenger would be God's special messenger, the Messiah God promised to send.
What else did God's people do wrong? Well, some of God's people were robbing God. When God gave people good gifts like money and wealth, the people kept it all for themselves. They did not share. They forgot that everything belongs to God. God said, "Give what you have, just a little bit of it. See what happens. I will give you even more blessings, more good things than you can count."
What else did God's people do wrong? Well, some of God's people were saying things about God that were not true. They said, "Serving God is no good. People who do not serve God have better lives than we have." "A day is coming," God said, "when everyone who is wicked will be punished. They will see that it is good to serve God. People who honor me will be happy, and they will jump and play like calves."
Malachi was a messenger for God. He said another messenger was coming. That messenger was John the Baptist. John's job was to get people ready for the last messenger, Jesus. Jesus is God's son. He came to rescue people from sin.
God sent Malachi to talk to his people, and he told the people that they were doing wrong. Malachi told them that God wanted his people to obey him. He told them another messenger is coming. Malachi said a messenger would get people ready for the Messiah. That messenger was John the Baptist. John's job was to get people ready for Jesus. Do you remember our big picture question and answer from last week? Who is in control of everything? God is in control of everything. His people waited for God to bless them. When nothing happened, they wondered if God really loved them. But God was working out his good plan to give them and us the best blessing of all, Jesus. Jesus came to rescue us from sin. God's people were happy that they had rebuilt the temple and fixed the walls around their city, but they were sad when they wondered if God really loved them. God did love them, and he loves us too. God wanted the people to know that Jesus was coming to rescue them from sin. He wanted them to obey him, and he promised to give them more blessings than they could count. Do you think they were surprised that God wanted to give them so many blessings? They needed to remember that God is in control of everything. Let's sing our key passage song together.
God will himself restore you after you.
God's people were suffering. They thought that God did not care about them. God did care about his people, and they had been doing wrong things, and God wanted his people to obey him. God planned to bless and restore his people when they turned away from their sin and turned back to him. Let's close in prayer today. Dear God, you are good and powerful. You know what will happen in the future. You are in control. You sent Malachi to say that Jesus was coming. Help us to trust in Jesus to save us from our sin. Thank you for sending Jesus. In his name, amen.